That's an association of black defenders media meeting with Dr. McCorvey and Freddie Howard. Black defenders, this is a morning session with Dr. Michael McCorvey, the CEO of the National Association of Black Defenders. We will be talking about our coming up schedule for the year 2021. Good morning, Dr. McCorvey. Let's start with Twyla and the VA. Go ahead.
Yes, we're so excited. This upcoming year is going to be a grand finale for the National Association of Black Defenders. We have a lot on the table, and one of the programs that we have on the table is the VA, Veterans Administration. One of our directors and board members, Ms. Twyla Jackson-Merkin, will be working with us on putting together several programs since she is the Southeast manager for the VA. She works out of the Montgomery, Phoenix City, and Opa-locka and Auburn, Alabama offices. And she's going to do a segment for the monthly segment for the National Association of Black Defenders. And her segment is going to deal, the first one is going to be about racism and the VA, which is a heavy topic, racism and the VA. And she'll be talking about collaborating on some of the problematic things that goes on within the walls of the VA. And we're excited about having her a part of this program, a worthwhile program that's well needed right now in times like these, dealing with our government affairs and government officials. And some of this will be brought to the attention, to the forefront of the local VA and what they're doing and what they're not doing, how they can improve the system, how they can make it better, how they can really touch the lives of the citizens around them, you know. And we just want to be inclusive. We want to be inclusive in this program. And we want to show the many members of the VA and those as a part of the VA how we can work together to make this a better and more sufficient system.
One of the things that is troubling is that so many VA representatives can't get no answers. Now, I filed a claim over 11 months ago, and every time I call them, they're trying to get my records. And they're trying to get my record. They're trying to get my, I hear that just like a broken record over and over. And everybody I call, it's the same thing. And another thing, I wanted a VA book that tells you all about your benefits. Guess who got to pay for that book? Hell, I got to pay for that book. If I want that book, I got to pay for it. Perhaps maybe the National Association of Black Defenders, I don't know how much that book costs. And when a person called and needs a book as a special introduction offered to them, we offer to the VA person a introduction book where you can know all your benefits and everything you're supposed to get. And the number one thing I would say is the VA people that are frustrated need the VA number for suicide prevention, because a lot of VA's veterans are killing themselves now. And the National Association of Black Defenders, we can become a workable, viable part of this country in meeting VA needs. We have our own representative, Ms. Twyla, and she can give out her number where folks can call her at any time and deal with their problem. But the thing of it is, the VA is just backed up. Maybe we can begin to send folks to VA to be hired, to work in records or whatever. And I don't, with this COVID thing, this stuff is just all messed up now. But anyway, thank you, Dr. McCorvey, for bringing that to the forefront and making that materialize here in 2021. And that is a VA contact person on the National Association of Black Defenders.
And we want to
homepage. Go ahead.
We want to preemphasize that they are. I count some of it for bureaucracy, because we get called filibustering with all the politics that's going on a lot of times on the Hill in D.C. until a lot of it become just this bureaucracy, you know, and we having to deal with it as a citizen, and we don't know the ins and outs of the system. when it comes to the VA, which is very important because you have to understand the ins and out of that system, you know, and on a literal base, we don't have no one that can actually locally give us the direct information. It's like sometimes when you're talking to government officials, they take you around the merry-go-round bush, and then they tell you that, okay, we can help you, and this can happen, and that can happen. But when it comes to giving you the direct information, our citizens, our people that don't understand the system, which is about 90% of us, we get lost because we don't have an understanding of what's going on. Then they don't try to explain or break down, okay, if you take this route right here, if you go in this direction here, nobody on Capitol Hill does that. I'm going to be honest with you. I work in D.C. Nobody does that. Okay. Good deal.
Don't have it. VA benefits and contacts. So he needs to have that information on that page as an item on the sitemap. VA benefits.
Mm-hmm.
And the contact person at the VA. All right. We also need to have, let's talk about Ms. Edna Gooch. That's in regards to drug rehabilitations, prison time, getting out of prison and trying to find jobs. In other words, talking about the life in prison, getting out of prison, what it's like in there, where people can contact her and talk to about the situation in prison. You go ahead and talk about Ms. Gooch.
Okay. Ms. Edna Gooch is one of our board members. She's over prison reform and transitional homes for the National Association of Black Defenders. Ms. Gooch will be bringing to the table rehabilitation programs that's going to serve all over the country. She will have a base in West Virginia, but she will serve all over the country when it comes to prison reform and even criminal justice reform, because we're going to make sure she get her certification as a lobbyist to go behind the scene and really look at some of the issues that our system is facing when it comes to criminal justice reform, which we stand in need of right now, especially with the outbreak of police brutality, death of George Floyd really opened that door up, believe me. And we want to talk about these subject matters. And Ms. Gooch, she's the one that's handling these subject matters and others when it comes to prison reform, criminal justice reform, and the system. She's the one that's going to be speaking to us on these matters as we begin to build our transitional home there in West Virginia, Charleston, West Virginia. And also we want to put a home, a transitional home, a halfway house in the Monroe County, Alabama area. And we want this to be for the young men that's getting out so we can train them, retrain them when it comes to job advocacy, when it comes to vocational rehabilitation, when it comes to getting them back in society again. We just don't want to turn them out into the streets so they can go back and do the same thing that ended them up in prison. But we want to have a rehabilitation program in place so when they leave there, you know, and this is so vital, and just turn them out into the streets is no good. When they leave there, they have a different frame of mind. When they leave our transitional program, they have a different frame of mind. They will know how to go build a house. They'll know how to buy a house. They'll know how to work on their job and maintain a job. So these are some of the things that we want to have in place this upcoming year when it comes to prison reform and criminal justice reform through Ms. Edna Gooch.
Let's talk a little bit about the schedule for the National Association of Black Defenders. Starting in January, February, and March of 2021, Our first event takes place January 11th. January 11th at 6 p.m. Central Standard Time and 7 p.m. Eastern Standard Time. All right? That will be dealing with specifically human rights versus civil rights. Human rights versus civil rights. That's a 3-month-long conference calling, interacting with people on civil rights, human rights versus civil rights. It will run all the way from January, February, and March of 2021. Now, you want to talk about that briefly, what we'll be talking about in regards to the person that will be the main person running that is Dr. Michael McCorvey Sr. Or his designate. Human rights versus civil rights. Dr. Clayton Howard is the board member that deals specifically with that. Perhaps it will be both of them in a session. But anyway, it will be dealing with human rights versus civil rights. That's in January, February, and March. Go ahead.
Of course, Brother Howard. It would probably be me, myself, and Dr. Clayton Howard, and because he's our Deputy Commissioner of Human Rights. And we both will tackle this subject matter those 3 months, and we both want to show the difference between human rights and civil rights. We want to point out how can we obtain the right information from the civil rights movement of the 1940s, 50s, 60s, and early 70s. How can we go back in law and find the legal documentation to prove the grounds of civil rights in that era? You know, and what was so momentous in that era, and what was need to be brought out that's not being spoken of today when it comes to civil rights. It was some laws that was put in place during the civil rights movement of the 40s, 50s, and 60s, and early 70s, that has not, that's enacted, including the voter right program, that has not been enacted on, that has not, we got to sometimes go back and reinvent the wheel when it comes to civil rights, because we have to understand the law. We have to understand the principles of what this country is supposed to be built on, and we got to understand the movement. You know, so very important when it comes to civil rights. So very important. We need to go back to that Civil Rights Act of 1964, the Civil Rights Act of 1968, and look at the Reconstructed era as well. You know, which goes back further than that. You know, so these are just some of the things that we need to talk about and bring out to the forefront to the public, because the public needs to know that this is something that just didn't start, that our Civil Rights Act from 1964 and 68, this is what started the whole major movement when it comes to voter registration. You know, so we're going to exemplify and expound these months on the Civil Rights Act and human rights. Human rights deal basically with the things that's going on now and things that has took place in the past when it comes to the analogy of our rights as citizens. And regardless to race, nationality, color, sexuality, and the list goes on. You know, we have been defamed, I want to say it like that, from exemplifying our rights as U.S. citizens. You know, so we want to get back into that. And we want to point out our to our audience and to our different groups that we do have rights. And you need to understand your rights. You know, even when it comes to, I talked about housing a while ago, even when it comes to fair housing, you need to understand your rights. You need to understand why we have this law in place. that so many people have been violated when it comes to affordable housing and fair housing in the last, I don't have to go back